The Darlington Nuclear Station is undergoing a refurbishment to extend its life by 30 years. But first, it's necessary to remove, process, and store the old reactor components. This will be accomplished by practicing good stewardship with lasting solutions to protect the environment both today and in the future.
The key to the Darlington refurbishment lies in the replacement of the 960 feeder tubes and 480 fuel channels that run through each reactor, known as the retube and feeder replacement. I'm Cameron Webb, the logistics lead for this part of the job. This work is vital for a successful Darlington refurbishment.
OPG is carefully planned and trained for every step of the project, including the development of specialized tooling and facilities to manage the activated materials that will be removed from the reactor during refurbishment. First, components are cut and removed from the reactor using sophisticated tools and highly trained staff. The components and materials are transferred to shielded transport flasks, and the materials are then safely transported through the station to the newly built retube and waste processing building.
I'm Joe Cicchini, Field Section Manager in Radiation Protection. The pre-authorized transfer route starts from here at the flask transfer area, then moves along an approved transfer corridor, ending in the retube waste processing building. Radiation protection technicians follow each transfer along the path.
The materials removed from the reactor are processed and stored, depending on the level of activation. Low-level waste that is essentially non-hazardous does not need processing and is shipped to a licensed facility in metal containers. Intermediate-level materials that have higher levels of activation undergo volume reduction processing before being placed in shielded containers to protect workers and the environment.
I'm Roy Brown, and I'm the Senior Director, RFR Projects. The waste tooling system, which you see behind me, or WTS, is a state-of-the-art, fully automated system used to process intermediate-level refurbishment waste.
Retube Waste Processing Building was designed by SNC-Lavalin, built by ATS Automation, and constructed by Akon, who also operates the facility. The processing involves reducing the environmental footprint of the used materials and their safe storage. Some materials are cut and crushed to reduce the storage volume. For speed and efficiency, there are two identical production lines that process and package the materials into shielded containers. The containers are moved through the workstations by an automatic trolley system, which controls their movement with extraordinary precision as they are filled and the lids are securely attached. End fittings are automatically uploaded from the station transportation flasks and then cut and separated into two pieces. The inboard segments, which were closer to the reactor and have higher activation levels, are not volume reduced and are transferred directly into a shielded container. And the less activated ends, which are low-level waste, are stacked in steel bins by a robotic arm. This workstation handles the pressure tubes and CALANDRIA tubes, which are processed to use less storage space. The tubes are inserted into a checkerboard press, where they are crushed and cut into 2-inch pieces. The pieces drop directly into the waste container, and sensors monitor when the container is full. Once filled, the next step is to seal the containers by installing lids. A camera system allows the operator to precisely position the lid on the container. Next, the lids are placed on the containers and securely fastened using a high-torque nut driver system. 2-inch thick steel doors provide shielding for workers during the lidding process. And for additional control, the area is enclosed within 2-foot thick concrete walls. All of the retube waste containers are also placed inside custom housings called dry storage overpacks or DSOs. They provide additional shielding and are designed to be easily and securely transported and stored.
I'm Fred Mason, the manager for the Darlington Waste Management Facility. The retube waste storage building was designed and constructed to store reactor components from all 4 Darlington reactors. These containers will remain in this building for up to 25 years, until the containers are transported for their final storage at OPG's intermediate level waste site in Kincardine, Ontario.
On a project of this size and complexity, our goal relies on each and every person to ensure the Darlington refurbishment project meets its regulatory, ministry and environmental requirements while safely completing time-sensitive work. Our employees are proud of what they do and do their work with purpose to give the public peace of mind.